Hello and welcome to Star Trek Online. It has been quite a while since we actually made any progress with Risrikas here, and there's been a lot of developments in the Star Trek Online universe in that time. Delta Rising, the latest expansion, has launched, and everyone else is running off to the Delta Quadrant to go and save people. We're not. We're going to stay down to Earth for now. We're going to carry on working our way through all the traditional story missions. However, before we get too excited, I have been sent a little bit of a gift from one of my fellow fleet mates. I hope I'm not going to butcher this name too much, but thank you very much to @Sortress, who has provided me with 5 1,000 skill point bonus pools. These will give us 20% skill points until we've received a total of 1,000 additional skill points per pool. So we're going to go and activate all 5 of these. Thusly. And that means that we can now earn an additional set of skill points much quicker. Somewhere there is a boost cell, which I'll just bring back. There we go. So you see we have 5,000 skill points left to get. I'll pop this bar somewhere where it can be out of the way. There. That will do for now. So let's get going. We currently have an active mission to secure the Hfihar System, which I think is just a little patrol, so we might just skip that for now. But we do have the mission Frozen, which requires us to go to the Dera System. So let's take the short route and get underway. Ah, yes, our little killing machine of doom. Let's begin Frozen. Measurement and signature intelligence tells us that the Reman resistance has been using this system as a hub for activity, but we do not have an exact location for the base. We need to convince the Resistance to talk to us, and sending messages on one of their encrypted communication channels should do the trick. Okay. So, we need to go and find one of their communications arrays, which is right here. Oh, yes. So we need to get close to this communications array. Like this, we can alter it, and then we can now back into this little micro nebula, and they won't be able to see us when they come and inspect the little alteration that we've just made. There we go, and send the signal. Oh. Well, that went well. The Reman ship is cloaked, but it's damaged, and they're... Oh, we've got a tachyon leak, so we can find them. We need to distract the Romulans so that the Remans can get away. Otherwise, they'll be destroyed. And we need them to stay alive in order to find the base. So, as a Romulan, let's engage the Romulans. These are the must be Tal Shiar Romulans. Oh, that didn't take long.
Your death shall be quick, but not merciful.
No, no, no. No, your death, not mine. I'm going to survive. Oh, we're famous, the RRW Rovaran. Yep, they tell you that's good. Oh well, let's get rid of them. The Derodex Battlecruiser. Yeah, well, I'm in a ship. What's it called? Oh, call it Tactical Warbird. I think I've probably got the nip on you. Right, so, let's see how much we can remember how to fly this thing. Oh, that's a good start. That's a lot of torpedoes. Thankfully, I have the power to take you apart. And the Remans scout ship has decloaked. Just repair up quickly. On my way, we can now see that we have spent 21 of our bonus skill points. Not sure how many we received for that little bit of combat. Oh, it doesn't say. I know it says somewhere, but I never find it, so let's not waste too much time. The Remans have decloaked, and we need to follow them to find the base, so we need to get after them because they're running away! Interact. Alrighty. That's a big nacelle they've got going. That'd be this visible from 15 kilometers out. But we are slowly gaining on them, so that's good. In fact, we're now gaining a bit too quickly. Let's just back off the speed. And again. Now they're getting away. Sheesh, fly straight already. Your warp engines may be damaged, but your impulse engine seems fine. Drop out a full impulse because we're basically here now. Nope, and they've ducked off, fine. Romulans. Mogai! Goodbye, Mogai. Let's get rid of those tractor beam mines quickly. Ooh, he's a vicious little one. And now he's a dead little one. Just heal up again. Ah, the Remans have decloaked. That's good. And they've walked out through a rock. That's not so good. They're in a short walk jump. Okay, let's go follow them. Picking up any ships, but there probably are some. So we need to scan for tetrion particles, because that could indicate the Reman cloak ships. Ooh, a large underground installation. Ah, the base we've been looking for. Alright. We'll try and find a way down. Oh, that was quick. And we'll take our usual away team with us. Ooh, a natural underground cave, but the base is a Dederodex that's been basically buried here. Okay, so we need to find a way into the ship. And it's guarded by animals. Fantastic. Let us go and investigate. Ooh, mature Jackal Mastiff and some other Jackal Mastiffs for the looks of things. Should probably put down some turrets and stuff, but in fact, let's do that. Let's have a quantum mortar here. And we'll put a cover shield in front of it, just to protect it. And we'll put down some turrets, I think here. There we go. And surprise! This isn't a particularly difficult section of combat. So that will go pretty sniffly as we enter. Ooh, some technology. And more Jackal Mastiffs. Ah, the entrance should be just ahead. So let's try and get through there in one piece. Ah, they've sealed off the entrance to the base with a gate. That's very nice of them. Tritanium alloy, very tough. Need something more than the weapon. Ah, there's a mining laser behind us. Let's go and blast a hole with this conveniently placed mining laser. Controls are here. And it's broken. But that's okay, because I'm sure as an engineer we will be able to fix it. First of all, we need to work out what is broken. The power system isn't strong enough. And there are several ways based on our different career trainings. We're an engineer, what can we do? Determine the cause of a problem before you attempt to solve it. Yes, that makes sense. Run a level 1 diagnostic on the mining laser's power system. Find and use a diagnostic terminal. Where is one of them? We need it. Ah, there it is, went the long way. Never mind. Running a diagnostic. No malfunctions in the laser, but the power supply is inadequate. So we need to replace the power conduits to increase capacity. Okay. Now, to complete this mission, there are three options. The engineering, science and tactical option. Completing each of these will earn you a career-specific accolade. If you play this on a team with other career-chosen captains, you will be able to gain all three accolades and be the rival of your friends. That was easy. There should be one in here. Yes, there it is. Oh, great. Ice spiders. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that name. So that's two done. And there should be a third one. We've done that one. There should be a third one around somewhere. Apologies for the wild camera swinging. Ah, there it is. I smell spiders. Oh, I was correct. Need to get some drones out to help us. Not that the spiders take too much killing anyway. They're more a minor nuisance than an enemy. And that is us done, and there is our accolade, Mr. Fix-It. Mining laser is ready and able to go. So if you are working with allies of the different career options, you still have time, having completed one, to complete the other two, as long as nobody rushes up to here and decides to press the big red go button. Now you'd think somebody might notice that. The other Remans will probably accept you as one of their own. Commander Opasek, what Smith wants to see? Oh! So you've suddenly gone from breaking our way into this base to being expected. Ooh, that's still powered up. Let's get out of here quickly. Oh, there's a door here, that's why they didn't notice. Chum-pum-pum. Hey, they have accepted us. They're safe, but they don't think for much longer. That's understandable. Wow, that's dark. But they are obviously expecting us. You just said they were planning to talk to us, Tovan. Make your mind up. Yeah, good grief. So there's an awful lot of Remans in here. I'm not going to go and talk to all of them, despite the options available. And if I remember correctly, just through here we have Obisek.
This place won't be safe forever. We have to be ready to leave at a moment's notice. Prepare the...
Oops.
Ah, it's you. Welcome to the heart of the Resistance, little spy. There is so much for us to discuss, and so little time. The Tal Shiar have discovered this, our last refuge. They will be here soon, and my people and I will have to fight for our lives. Yet one question remains. Will you be our friend, or our enemy?
So we first met Obisek in the vault, and then he basically tried to kill us. And now we're here, he's almost welcoming us with open arms, but we have to decide whether we're going to be friendly or enemies.
My hope is that you are here to talk, but I am prepared for the alternative.
Ooh.
The Tal Shiar could arrive at any time. Speak quickly.
So why have I got so many dialogue options? Oh, good grief. Right. Why are you doing this?
Why? You ask why? This place is one of the last sanctuaries left to us, and even it is lost to us now. The Romulans have driven us from our homes, destroyed our ships, and captured or killed our loved ones. They seek to exterminate us, and we will not go quietly.
Okay.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Did Sela order these attacks?
This campaign of terror is the Tal Shiar's doing, not the Empress's. Still, Sela does nothing to stop it. There is little love between the Empress and the Tal Shiar. Did you know that many years ago, she was exiled from Romulus for attempting to assassinate the head of their order? The Tal Shiar have their own masters, and Sela despises what she cannot control.
Okay.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
I think we already know the answer, but why do you think the Tal Shiar are doing this?
Hakiv and the Tal Shiar no longer serve the Empire. The demons of air and darkness are their masters now. They whisper in the night for chaos and despair, and Hakiv gives them blood as tribute. Our blood.
Demons of air and darkness.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Tell me more about them.
I have never seen one of these demons, and I will not speak their name, but I know they exist. Eons ago, they ruled this part of the galaxy. After thousands of years of tyranny and death, the races they ruled rose up against them, driving them from their home world into unexplored space. We thought they had been destroyed. We were wrong. The demons of air and darkness survive, and they hunger for revenge.
Oh dear.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Okay, let's be blunt. Do you still have Phaeron weapons?
A small supply. They are terrible things. Weapons of war so horrible, they should never have been invented at all. But they were. And my enemies are great. If I must resort to barbarism to free our people, that is not too high of a price to pay.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Why can you not talk at one consistent volume level? Have you tried to find a peaceful solution?
There will be no peace, not while Hakiv lives. This is not a problem that can be solved by diplomacy. Hakiv kills our people. I kill his. That is how it will be until one of us is dead.
Okay.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
What do you want from me?
We need your help. You are one of us. Talk to your connections among the other powers of the Quadrant. Tell them what you have seen. Tell them if our people are to survive, we need assistance. Starships, soldiers, medicine, protection for the refugees. We will fight alone if we must. But I know there are many who cannot simply stand by and watch our people suffer. We must have a chance to fight for our freedom. You know what we face. We face the same enemies. Please, let us be unified in this. Our people cannot fight for themselves if we are fighting each other.
Wise words.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
So now we have three options. If you are a Federation or Klingon Empire officer, you'll only have two. You will have the surrender and I'll see you treated fairly. I may not agree with your tactics, but I will not stop you options. As we are a Romulan, or in fact possibly could be just because we are Reman even, we have a third. I will not fight my own kind. I will not stop you. Let's go for it.
I knew that I could count on you. We shall both be remembered for our commitment to this cause. Tell your allies what you must, but if they are truly your allies, they will understand your need to help us. With your help, our people will be free.
Yes, we will.
I'm pleased you see that my cause is just. We can do great...
Sir, Romulan transporter signals detected.
I will return to my ship and attempt to hold off their forces. Help my soldiers defend this base. Start the evacuation. We must get the civilians out.
The Tal Shiar have entered the base.
Commander Roshna, transport the reinforcements here. Tell them to assist our new ally.
Security forces transporting.
Fight well, my friend. My people are counting on you.
Okay. Tell us your troops are beamed down all over the base. The Remans will be overwhelmed as we can stop them. If we place transport inhibitors in overlapping fields and keep the Tal Shiar from sending down reinforcements. Ooh. So this is slightly new territory for me now. Like I said, I've always been Federation or Klingon, so I've never actually played this little Reman option. So we now have to take out these Tal Shiar. Now the cutscene there was very, very similar, if not identical, to the Federation letting go option. However, this little section is very, very different. Having let them go normally, we just have to kill the Tal Shiar here. We have to deploy transport inhibitors. Normally you just have to kill and then disable the transport inhibitor to stop, which prevents us from beaming out, I think. Oh, flanking damage. What I'd give for a grenade about now. And let's just clear this lot out. Yay, a new accolade! Which side are these guys on? They're going to be on that side, so we'll go and take out these guys first. I'll jump over these icy patches because they're a little bit wibbly underfoot. That won't do bad. Let's get some turrets. Oh, someone was keen. Some drones and kill. And shields. Oh, great, Thedon radiation. Thank you. Take the item and see if we can deploy. Nope, we can't deploy the inhibitor while we're injured. There we go. So everyone's back to near enough full health. So we can come round here and surprise these guys. Put another beam turret down quick. Use a hypo. Right. Deploy this last transport inhibitor, and then we should be done. Yay, frozen, complete. The Reman resistance will be able to evacuate with minimal losses. We should return to the ship and report in. Romulans and Remans working as equals is another nail in the coffin of the old ways. Acknowledging the contributions of the Reman people will mean greater cooperation. and remove any reason that OPSEC may have to use Thaderon weapons while he's hoarded. We may have had differences in the past, but if Romulans and Remans are going to have a future, it may be best to face our challenges as allies. Indeed. So, let us go. And that truly is Frozen done. We need to report to Admiral Tanai at Starbase 39 Sierra.
I sympathize with Obasek's plight, but I do not know if we will be able to assist him. He has no proof of these demons that he claims are directing Haki's actions. Without that, becoming directly involved in this conflict would be a violation of the Prime Directive. We will protect the Federation, offer aid to the refugees, and keep this conflict from spilling over into our territory. But if Obasek and his followers are going to continue this fight, they will do so without Starfleet support.
Well. So we are going to receive nearly 9,000 skill points, a little over 9,000 expertise, and a Romulan Disruptor Y-beam pistol or Romulan Disruptor split beam rifle. I think I'll take the split beam rifle, thank you very much.
Congratulations.
And we are now level 37, and not that far from level 38. Wow. And we've taken a huge chunk out of our skill point boosts, which are doing us very nice. So thank you, Admiral Tanai. And that is going to be the end of today's little stint. That's Frozen done, another one of the featured episodes. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.